Well, welcome back, my friends, to another rousing rendition of Choir Boys Outdoors, a Jed Hornbeak Coffin handled Bowie knife rendition, if you will. For 3 years, I've told you guys this channel was all about function. We worried about how the knife worked, wasn't worried about the fit and finish, not worried about the design. Does it work? And that's why a lot of times, guys, you don't hear a lot of negativity. It's not about finding it. It's just about making the knife work. And yet, for 2.5 years, I've told you everything about Jed Hornbeak based on fit, finish, quality, etc. Somehow, this is the first hard use video I've ever done with a Hornbeak knife. And I'm kicking myself now. I kicked myself before. This is one of the best knives, hands down, most enjoyable Bowie knives I've ever tested. That ain't no shit. I'm telling you that straight up, man to woman, however you want to say it. This is a badass custom knife. Now, here's the deal. And honest to God, I've always viewed Jed's stuff. You can look at something and tell its quality by the make. You can. But you can't really tell about the function until you use it. Let's deep dive this thing. Before we do, guys, I'm going to do my intro, and then we'll go straight into stats, and then we'll get just thoughts on the knives. Now, if you're new here, guys, do me a favor. Just, if you want, turn the volume down, watch the knife work, come back and listen to my melodious tones. Here's the deal. There was a time in this country where 22 veterans a day took their own lives. Stats are everywhere. We're in a holiday weekend. Those numbers will be increasing. That is why, however, that this channel focuses on the number zero. Anything over zero is simply unacceptable. Vets, we love you. You have a place here. That's all that means. We're not a charity, not trying to be. Just trying to raise some awareness and let you know you are welcome here. We back to blue over here. Oh, my God, it wears people out. And I'm sorry it does. That's why we live in the good old USA, and you can do what you want. I choose to. Why? Well, my kids want me a cop. I got friends that are cops. I believe in the law. Are there bad ones? Sure there are. How do you support them, Scab? Well, I don't break the damn law. I used to do it every day. You can look at me and tell. You can see that bullet hole right here in my left leg if you don't believe me. Now I try to do it by just upholding the law. Finally, if you are an addict, never quit quitting. And no, those three causes have nothing to do with each other. They're three separate causes that we've adopted on this channel. I am an addict. That is the truth. And that's probably one of the reasons you see so much content from me. I'm scared to death to have idle hands. That being said, let's move into the knife. This is the Hornbeak Coffin Handle Bowie. It is an A2 tool steel. I believe it's 5/16 thick handle stock, which means stock material, 5/16. Overall length, 12 7/8. Blade length, 7 3/4. Cutting edge, 7 1/8. Blade width at its widest point, 2 inches. You can see how deep that damn thing is sticking, right? That's probably the furthest I get away for those throws is 5. Now, pay attention here to how this thing sails through this nylon strap, 2-inch strap. It comes with a leather sheath. Jed does all his custom sheaths. Yes, he's that talented. You see his logo, a little bit of billboarding on the knife. You see it on the sheath. It's very, very well done. The handle length is 5 inches, and I believe those are micarta handle scales. I really do. The inner grip is 4 1/4. This thing fits like a glove. God, it's such a nice feeling knife. The handle thickness, we do blade thickness, we do handle thickness, is 3/4 inch. The handle width, now this is a coffin handle buoy, so I'm going to give you three widths. We're going to start with the width right below the guard. It's 1 7/8. The middle width is 1 inch. The bottom at the pommel is 1 9/16. I personally, if a coffin handle buoy or coffin handle anything is done right, I adore it. Now you see what we did there? We just carved that out. That's how sharp this damn knife is. Guys, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going to be straight up with you. I'm a dumbass. Plain and simple. Now, And why do I, this is a 1-inch thick piece of tire tread. We're going to go straight down. Takes a minute because it's a 1-inch piece of tire tread. It's not steel belted, okay? I found this particular tire tread on the side of the road, and I thought, man, this is perfect for stabbing, for cutting, etc. We're going to stab a tire. Y'all know that. But I just wanted a thick, hard, tough surface. Now watch here. Boom. Look at that. Through both of them, look at that. And I know there's some treads there, okay? I know the thickness varies. I get it. We're doing the John Peter stab test. I'm going to throw a third on. I don't think it ever really stabbed three, but it was consistent too. That's a hell of a stabber right there. Now, it's got a nice little garden. And here's the thing, man. Let me explain something to you about Jed. Jed is the damn salt of the earth. You hear what I'm telling you, son? If you can't get along with Jed, you can't get along. What does that mean? It means that he's not only a hell of a knife maker, he is a good moral man. If you deal with Jed one-on-one, and I always talk all that shit. I'm not the QVC. I will put my name on Jed Hornbeak. I'll put my reputation. I don't care what goofy son of a bitch comes along and hits it with a bat and tries to break it. I don't care. This is a hell of a knife. It's a tough knife that held up. We're going to do some hard use on it. That normal hard use right here. It works. It's tough. It's thick. But you know what it's not? It's not a sharpened pry bar that does you no good in a survival situation. It is a knife that is a cutting tool that's sharp as shit. And again, that ain't taking a shot at nobody, son. Skill set has to count for something. It has to. Now, we pounded it into that 4x4. I want to give you a good look. Look at that edge. The bevels are done right. It's sharp as shit. It's A2. I'm going to get hyped about this knife. I'm telling you that right now. I stopped in the middle of this video and walked in the house and stopped Meg from what she was doing and said, I am an idiot. And she gave me that like, yeah, okay, that's not really a shocker, babe. I love you, but she said, why, babe? And I told her, I said, I've been basing all this stuff on Hornbeak and pumping up Hornbeak based on fit, finish, because that's been gorgeous. That's not my thing. But you know when a knife is put together well. You know by the materials. You know by the quality. You know by the machine work, by the hand work. You know by all that. But I said, until I started using it, I'm going to tell you right now, I'm doing this review today. I've got the Kermit Hornet, which is a little boot knife. I'm going to do it. Jed's sending some knives. Now listen, this knife is from Donnie B. All Day. We are in full swing trying to raise money for Donnie, having some serious health issues. We are having a knife raffle. Jed is raffling, is sending me a knife we can raffle off. That's one of the reasons. I'm just going to be honest with you. It's one of the reasons I wanted to get this hard use review in as quick as I did. But I'm so glad I did. I am so glad I did. Because this thing, I'm telling you right now, this thing is a beast. It's just a monster. And here's why I'm calling it that. Because it's sharp? Yes. Because it's thick? Yes. Because it is a cutting tool that you can use as a cutting tool. But if you needed to pry with it, if you need to baseball bat something with it, if you need it for self-defense, you can do that. We started off chopping. Is it a chopper? No. No. The damn thing is crazy. It is balanced damn near perfectly. So that, you know, more in the handle. It's more of a fight. Look at him move right here, son. More of a fighting knife, right? And there ain't many knife fighters left. Let's just go ahead and admit it. It's good to know that you can use it in that situation. It's also good to know that you can use it for everyday stuff. This tire is steel belted. Went through it like a chainsaw. Like it wasn't there. Now, we've stabbed the shit out of this tire a bunch. So finding spots, I'm running out of spots on this side. So I did find some. But then what I did too is stabbed around some areas that were cut. I'd go an inch below or an inch above where it's flimsier. You could tell how sharp a knife is, how stabby a knife is, not when the tire's fully intact. And right here, I wish I got a better camera angle because I'm just making some cuts, just coming straight down. I cut literally everything I could. This was about a 25-minute video, seriously. And I whittled it down to what I got here, right? I tried to pick some of the stuff to show you all the way around. The chopping. Let me say this about the chopping. There was no shock in the handle. Now, I opened with a piece of oak. This is that hackenberry, hackbush, whatever the hell it is. All right? Now, I tried to use some harder woods, and we're just spinning right here. I like doing this particular chopping test because I'm holding the log. Now, at the front, that log, I was holding it. What does that tell you? Even though this isn't like, and when I say a dedicated chopper, usually dedicated choppers are weight forward. The weight's more in the blade, not in the handle. But this thing will hold its own for whatever you need to hold its own for. It is a tank of a knife, a truck of a knife that I would gladly put my name on. And you see right there, see all the little markings and crap? And right here, we're going to make a little punji stick, tent stake type stuff, just to show you a little bit of finer work. I'll be honest with you, I need to get better at my finer skills with the knife. It's a work in progress. Yes, we do industrial testing, but I want to get better at the finer skills. Again, to me, skill set matters. I can't answer for anybody else. I can answer for me. The better I can get at doing things, the better look of a knife I can give you. That's just the way I view it. This thing is a monster. It is a beast. And it's comfortable in hand. I could have been out there all day long. No blisters on my hands. No shock in the hands. Now, this is a limb that I had, I guess, cut on one time out there. Somebody else, meth crafter, cut. It's just an old dried out piece of log that we're going to hit flat. Now, we got a minute left. Guys, listen. The situation with Donnie's serious. I'm dead serious. I'll have more news on the raffle by the end of the week. I've got knives coming in for that. Okay? If you want to know how you can help with that, please reach out. Feel free to reach out at choirboyscutlery@gmail.com. I believe that's the email. And I'll be glad to fill you in. Jed, you are a hell of a knife maker and a hell of a man. I'm telling y'all, I can kick myself for waiting this long. I'm so excited about the knives coming up. Hey, if you want to reach out to Jed, reach out to him on Facebook. I'm sorry, not Facebook. On Instagram. Or hit the link in the title. I'm tagging Jed in the title. But remember this before you remember anything else. I'm Scab. You're not. I'm gone, son. Damn, that's a buoy. Woo!